Good evening and welcome back to Eminem. It's like Christmas morning. I get to open up a gift. It's funny, you know, when I'm getting these recommendations and I get hundreds of people asking me for the same song, and it's like, man, talk about curiosity peaked. Yeah, there's a couple of people out there that are spoilers. It's about his dad, I guess, or something. Kind of like a good Dear John letter to his dad or something. And so some people have had really bad fathers in their lives. My dad was, I mean, no disrespect to my father. He's gone. Lost him a few years ago. But yeah, he was a friend and that kind of stuff. But he was messed up. I mean, he definitely had some issues, alcoholism and drug use and quite a bit of stuff, angry, drunk, the whole nine yards. So every once in a while, when I think about how he treated my mother, makes me want to kind of have a few words with him too. You know, and so here we are, leaving heaven. Really gets my mind going, like, what the heck are you talking about leaving heaven? Like, are we casting him out of heaven into hell? What's going on? What's going on? I know his dad's gone. And so here we go. Leaving heaven. Okay.
Yeah. I knew this day was coming. Sometimes you gotta come back down.
I'm going to hell now, man.
Stoop to someone's level.
Yeah. 5 dozen flies buzzing over your head. Call me the Grim Reaper. Sleep is my cousin. You dead to me now, and I'ma be the last face you see before you die, cousin. My eye a tiger's and I'm a survivor, so I will rise up and.
Look, love is chops here. Just chopping a little bit. I'm learning some lingo. You proud of me? Bars, chops. Wait, is it chops? Did I get the wrong one? Did I get the wrong word? Yeah, chops. Anyways, I like the rhythm. I like it a lot. Look, what is there not to like about Eminem? Come on. All right, back up to the beginning here, if you don't mind. So sometimes you got to come back down, stoop to someone else's level. This must be Eminem. Could it be Eminem in heaven going down to hell to stoop down to his level? Is that what I'm hearing?
This day was coming. Sometimes you gotta come back down.
I'm going to hell now, man.
Stoop to someone's level.
Yeah. 5 dozen flies buzzing over your head. Call me the Grim Reaper. Sleep is my cousin. You're dead to me now, and I'ma be the last face you see before you die, cousin. My eye a tiger's and I'm a survivor, so I will rise up and be triumphant, cause when I'm looking at my legacy, bunch of dogs.
Leg, I see. Cause when I'm looking at my leg, I see. Legacy. Okay.
Trying to dry hump it, might triumph the puppet. So I'm like, fuck it, pot of carnage up till it's so high it's touching the sky. Let them all line up and attack. Single filing up in a stack. Call them toy soldiers. Yeah.
There's that toy soldiers again. I got to do some more recon on toy soldiers. He's referenced that before. Back up a little bit again.
Fuck it, pot of carnage up till it's so high it's touching the sky. Let them all line up and attack. Single filing up in a stack. Call them toy soldiers. Yeah. Cause they just wind up on their backs. Now the sky is nothing but black, but I am not coming back. I done told ya, I told the woke me to go to sleep, but still they keep on provoking me. They're hoping to see me completely broken emotionally. But how in the fuck am I not supposed to be woke when these fuckers just keep poking me now?
I'm leaving hell.
Ooh.
I'm leaving hell.
Wow.
Angels won't follow me.
Whoa.
Around 6,000 times since I was a kid. As a child, picked up, clown, thick, countless times I've been outed. Gotta remind myself of it every now and then. So the route I went, self-empowerment in a hole. Taught myself how to get out of it and balance it with talents, wit, cause life.
Yeah. Wow. You know, this is why people gravitate to his music. They can relate. They find solace. They find relatability. Because he's brave enough to wear his heart on his sleeve and talk about how, I mean, let's go back even further here. I've been down, kicked like around 6,000 times since I was a kid. As a child, picked on, clowned, been countless times. I've been outed.
Countless times I've been outed.
Got to remind myself of every now and then. So the route I went, self-empowerment in a whole, taught myself how to get out of it and balance it with talents.
I remind myself of it every now and then. So the route I went, self-empowerment in a hole, taught myself how to get out of it and balance it with talents, with, cause life is like a penny, cause it's only 1% who overcome the shit they underwent. I went eight ball like what my back was up against. Don't tell me about struggle, bitch, I lived it.
Yeah.
I was 5 or 6 the first time I got my hind end kicked.
Yeah. I mean, hopefully it's more than just 1%. My prayer is that you all make that 1%. Don't let your past define you. Yes, granted, M took a bit of a turn. He circled the drain almost, like he was going down. He flat spinning, drug use, all of it. Got all caught up in it. Almost lost his family, lost his daughter, lost everything they loved. Penny.
What my back was up against. Don't tell me about struggle, bitch, I lived it. I was 5 or 6 the first time I got my hind end kicked. Malcolm Isaac and Boogie jumped me and took my tricycle. And I don't know if I would call that white privilege. Yeah, but I get it. How it feels to be judged by pigmen. Besides getting it from both sides of the tracks, but I swore I'd get them back, even if it meant selling my soul to get my revenge. And what? Thought of a scheme and it got me to thinking, if I could believe in myself, I could probably achieve it. That's part of the reason I feel I'm talking when he gets.
I love it. Wow. His speed. Yeah, Rap God was something insane. Man, had a brain reset on that song. Let me tell you, that's levels. But wow, he is, he's incredible.
What my back was up against. Don't tell me about struggle, bitch, I lived it. I was 5 or 6 the first time I got my hind end kicked. Malcolm Isaac and Boogie jumped me and took my tricycle. And I don't know if I would call that right.
What privilege at that age. That's privilege. Hilarious.
Yeah, but I get it. How it feels to be judged by pigment. Besides getting it from both sides of the tracks, but I swore I'd get them back, even if it meant selling my soul to get my revenge. And what? Thought of a scheme and it got me to thinking, if I could believe in myself, I could probably achieve it. That's part of the reason I feel I'm talking with ink. And as long as I'm breathing, I've out of my...
Talking with ink.
Smother me, beat him, a god with a heart of a demon. Go at him and I'ma get even, like I'm in the Garden of Eden. I'm about to go off of the deep end, cause evil is calling. I'm already seething and...
I'm leaving.
I gotta hear that again.
Wow. The first time I got my hind end kicked. Malcolm Isaac and Boogie jumped me and took my tricycle. And I don't know if I would call that white privilege. Yeah, but I get it. How it feels to be judged by pigmen. Besides getting it from both sides of the tracks, but I swore I'd get them back, even if it meant selling my soul to get my revenge. And thought of a scheme and it got me to thinking, if I could believe in myself, I could probably achieve it. That's part of the reason I feel I'm talking with ink. And as long as I'm breathing, I vow I smother me, beat him, a god with a heart of a demon. Go at him and I'ma get even, like I'm in the Garden of Eden. I'm about to go off of the deep end, cause evil is calling. I'm already seething and
I'm leaving heaven. I'm leaving heaven.
Love the vocals here. Beautiful.
So while Macklemore was keeping his room nice and neat,
yeah,
I was getting my ass beat twice a week. What? Looking for a place for the night where I could sleep.
Yeah.
Flipping sofa cushions open, just trying to see if I could find some change and scrape up a bite to eat. If denying me, find a couple dimes apiece. 25 cents each, you get us a bag of chips. We'd be glad to get, yeah, even if we had to split. We do backward flips, looking back at it. I think that would fit with the definition of not having shit. Couple that with the fact my mother was batshit.
This guy. I've never imagined that such a meaningful story can be put to rhythm and rhyme so eloquently. I don't know, okay, I'm going to describe where I'm at right now. Okay, here's where I'm at. I am, unlike Eminem, at a loss to describe the beauty of his art. It's almost beyond Prodigy, right? It's just, wow, man. What a waste of like 20, 30 years of not hearing his music, or however long he's been doing his thing. Man, I've said it before and I'll say it again, you know, just give something a chance. I've challenged some of you guys to listen to some of the Christian rock bands I've listened to in the day, just for fun, because all of our minds slam at one point or another. All of them slam shut. We turn our eyes to stuff thinking, no, I'm not even going to give it a chance. Man, what am I? I'm really digging this song, man. So many things he's saying. The pigment of his skin, being judged by it, being a white guy in a heavily talented black art, and being judged by his skin and them not giving him a chance. But then Dr. Dre comes alongside the guy and just mentors him. And I mean, just all the cool stuff, man. I can go on for days.
And a couple times a piece, 25 cents each, you get us a bag of chips. We'd be glad to get, yeah, even if we had to
split. Cute. I mean, is that neat?
Looking back at it, I think that would fit with the definition of not having shit. Couple that with the fact my mother was bad shit, Pop was a sack of shit. Yeah, he died, but I gave half a shit. Yeah, which brings me back to the dear old dad that I zero had since a year old 47-year-old scab. Just to hear them words, ear piercing, like my earlobe stabbed with a needle for an earring. Should I feel upset? You were dead to me before you died. Me, tear no shed. Should I have made a mirror at your funeral, had your coffin draped with a hero's flag? Where the fuck you were at when D'Angelo done hurt me real bad? At the Rio Grande, never met your grandkids. Fucking coward, only gut you had was from your stomach fat. I couldn't see your ass going to heaven, so I'm asking for a pass to go to hell so I can whip your fucking ass.
See? I called it. I called it. Man, I should write. I should write songs. Problem is, they wouldn't rhyme. They wouldn't have a rhythm. They wouldn't make any sense at all. I'd have to find a word to rhyme with my other bar that I came up with that I can't rhyme things with it. I mean, just think, wow, I really have mad respect for people that can do this. This is just crazy. This is just crazy. But that was just a great line.
At when D'Angelo done hurt me real bad. At the Rio Grande, never meet your grandkids. Fucking coward, only gut you had was from your stomach fat. Wow. I couldn't see your ass going to heaven, so I'm asking for a pass to go to hell so I can whip your fucking ass. I hate that I never get to say I hate you to your face. No coming back from where I'm going. Sky is dark, my soul is black. Hand on the shovel, dick with the blade of it that I stamp on the metal. Vendetta to settle, tell the devil
I'm leaving heaven.
Yeah, dig your motherfucking ass up just to spit in your fucking face. Hold my baby pictures up like you're proud of me. Fuck you, bitch. You know what? Maybe if I'd have had you, I wouldn't have went through half the shit I went through. So I blame you.
What? I just wish I could dig you up. I don't mean to laugh, but I'm laughing at the art, the insane storytelling is just a mind blow. May I just go back a little bit? I gotta get these again.
Don't tell the devil
I'm leaving heaven.
And his interjections between her singing I'm leaving heaven and he's just jumping in with his one-liners.
Yeah.
I'm leaving heaven.
fucking face. Holding my baby pictures up like you're proud of me. Fuck you, bitch. You know what? Maybe if I'd have had you, I wouldn't have went through half the shit I went through. So I blame you. Or maybe I should say thank you. Cause I wouldn't have been me. Yeah. So I'ma let it go now. Rest in peace. Cocksucker.
I knew a line was coming. Gosh. Something tells me he and his dad didn't get along too well. Jeez.
Or maybe I should say thank you. Cause I wouldn't have been me.
Yeah, you know, our upbringing defines us. I shouldn't say that. I take it back. Our upbringing doesn't define us. It tries to steer us. We define ourselves, right? What is the saying? There's a saying, an alcoholic had two kids. Someone asked one of the kids, how'd you end up to be such a crook? Well, my dad was an alcoholic. He asked the brother, how'd you end up to being such a nice guy? Well, my dad was an alcoholic, right? So it's what you make of your circumstances. And of course, Eminem had some demons to battle and worked things through. Same thing with his mother. Then he came up with Headlights, beautiful. So heart-touching. Castle and then a Rose, right? Beautiful. Redemption. Finding his way back. Making peace with the past. This has got to be a Slim Shady kind of thing, I'm assuming. This must be Slim Shady days. I'm only guessing. I don't know enough about the chronological sitch here. So if you wouldn't mind giving me a little help on that in the comment section, that'd be helpful. But let me just finish this up here.
So I blame you. Or maybe I should say thank you. Cause I wouldn't have been me. Yeah. So I'ma let it go now. Rest in peace. Cocksucker. See you in hell.
Oh, gosh. Oh, my goodness gracious. My goodness gracious. My goodness gracious. Wow. Okay. There you have it, folks. Eminem. Leaving heaven. Okay, love the music. Feel bad he was brought to a place to have to write a song like this. Love the background vocals. Absolutely loved his interjections during the chorus there of "I'm Leaving Heaven." Major crack up. But that's the funny thing is that he can bring lightness and laughter to something so deep. Wow. I can't take credit for this because somebody mentioned it to me in the comments when I mentioned he's a Rembrandt. He's not a Rembrandt. He's an Embrandt. Take care. Have a good night.